إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبد الله ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. وبعد، يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، always we begin by praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We send our prayers of peace upon the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We testify with full firmness that none is worthy of worship but Allah, and that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his worshipping slave and final messenger. I always continually remind myself and you to be aware of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to have taqwa Allah, which is the consciousness and the awareness that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is deserving of us, and to remain steadfast upon this faith of Islam and submission voluntarily to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala as long as that we may live. Today in assembly, our school received some sad news about one of the prominent members of our community. And in the morning, Sheikh Salim, he made a dua for the father of our brother and our colleague, for the teachers and the staff here with us at Langford Islamic College, of our brother Suhaimi and his family. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant his father the highest places of Jannah. And I thought to myself, I'm speaking with you here today, it's important for us as Muslims, even though there's young and old amongst us, to understand the journey of the soul. And this is one of the things that as a Muslim, it gives you hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his mercy. At the time of the Prophet ﷺ, there was a young boy. His name was Abu Umayr. He was maybe 4 or 5 years old, much younger than many of you. He would be like a primary, pre-primary student or a kindy student. Now this young boy, Abu Umayr, he had Nu'ayr. He had a sparrow that was his pet. And he used to have a cage for his sparrow, and he used to feed it and give it water. He used to clean it. And the sparrow would fly away and come back. The sparrow loved him and he loved the sparrow. And one day the Prophet ﷺ, sitting in his masjid, he hears of the death of the sparrow. Now you say to yourself, it's just a pet, just a little animal. But our Prophet Muhammad ﷺ looked for every opportunity to teach about the journey of life that leads us back to Allah. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. We belong to Allah. Allah owns you. Allah has given you life and He's the one who takes it from you. Young and old, healthy and sick, mature and not in age. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dispenses what He wills in His wisdom to whomever He wills and at whatever time. And this young boy, his sparrow died, and the Prophet heard of it. People were talking in the masjid, this young boy who used to come to the masjid, his sparrow died, and he's sitting in his room upset. Our Prophet ﷺ, he got up, and he took with him a sahaba to pay the boy a visit and talk to him about the death of his sparrow. And the Prophet comes to this boy, and the hadith is in Sahih al-Bukhari, and the whole hadith is one statement. The Prophet ﷺ says to him, Ya Aba Umayr, ماذا فعل النعير? Abu Umayr, what happened to your bird? And this is one of the wisdoms of the Prophet ﷺ, that as young as we may be, and as young as you are today, all of us must recognize that we have a return to Allah. And all of us must know that it's not about how old we are, or young we are, or how healthy we are. All of us return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when He decides. And there will be tragedies within our families, within our parents, within our communities, within our grandparents. May Allah give good long health and a long life and good deeds to all of them. What happened to your bird? I want to share with you today the authentic hadith narrated by the Imam Ahmad. And it's a hadith where the Sahaba, they sat with the Prophet ﷺ and they said, Ya Rasulullah ﷺ, after we die, what happens? And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, إِذَا كَانَ الْمُؤْمِنُ أَقْبَلَ إِلَى الْآخِرَةِ وَاسْتَبَّرَ الدُّنْيَا. When you turn your back to the dunya and now you're looking into the doorway of the next world, you're at the moment of your death. رَأَى مَلَكَان. You will see عند آخر طرفه, at the furthest sight of your eye, as far as your eye can see, in the greatest distance, you will see two angels descend from the heavens. بِيضُ الْوُجُوهِ. Bright faces. طَيِّبُونَ الرَّائِحَ. Beautiful in their scent. مَعَهُمْ حَنُوتٌ مِّنَ الْجَنَّةِ. And they will have something that they brought from Jannah to carry you in it. وَإِذَا اقْتَرَبَ أَجَلُكَ. And the Prophet ﷺ says, when your time is near, the angels come closer and closer and closer. حَتَّى يَجْلِسَ عِنْدَ رَأْسِكَ. Until they sit right next to your head. And they say to you as a believer, لَا تَخَفْ وَلَا تَحْزَنْ. Don't be scared. Don't be upset. Don't worry about your family. Allah will look after them. Don't fear. What you have in store will be good. And it's at that moment the angel of death appears. وَمَلَكَ الْمَوْتِ يَقْبِضُ رُوحَكَ. The angel of death grabs your soul. And your soul is you. It's you. It's how you look. But it's in a creation that we do not understand. It is a spirit. But it represents who you are. It's in every part of your body. وَيَنْتَزِعُ رُوحَ. And the angel of death grabs it and pulls it out. And the Prophet ﷺ says, when the angel takes your soul, it's as quick as you pour water into a cup. It moves quickly. It's fluid. It doesn't hurt. It doesn't get stuck. Water, when you pour it into something, it goes in, it moves right, left and center. It moves quickly. There's nothing that pushes it away. And the moment the angel of death takes the soul, the Prophet ﷺ says, those two angels, يَأْخُذُونَ الرُّوحِ. They grab you from the angel of death. وَيُكَفِّنُونَهُ بِحَنُوطِ الْجَنَّةِ. And they wrap your soul up in this covering that they brought down with them from heaven. And as they rise with you, ثُمَّ يَصْعَدَانِ إِلَى سَمَاءِ الدُّنْيَا. They come up to the gate of the heaven of our world. And there's angels protecting it. And the angels inside the heaven, they say, لِمَنْ هَذِهِ الرُّوحُ الطَّيِّبَةِ. To whose soul? Who does this soul belong to? وَيُسَمُّونَهُ بِأَحْسَنِ أَسْمَائِهِ. And they label you with the best names that people called you. They say, this is the great person. This is, you know, Yahya, the son of Adil, the son of Ibrahim. This is a good man. Rise up with him. The next heaven, and the next heaven, and the next heaven. حتى يبلغ السماء السابعة. Until they rise to the seventh heaven. And when they get to the seventh heaven, Allah makes a command. And this command is recorded to us in the Quran. أدخلوا روح عبدي في عليين. Write the name of this soul in the book of the highest, mightiest people who will enter Jannah. And you will feel happy. Your soul will feel happy. And then Allah will say, ثُمَّ أَعِيدُوهَا إِلَى الْأَرْضِ. Angels, take this soul back down to earth. فَمِنْهَا خَلَقْنَاهُمْ. Because it's from the earth they were made. وَمِنْهَا نُعِيدُهُمْ. And to the earth we promise to return them. وَمِنْهَا نُخْرِجُهُمْ تَارَةً أُخْرَى. And from the earth we will resurrect them. And your soul descends, the Prophet ﷺ says, وَتُرَفْرِفُ فَوْقَ الْجَسَدِ. And the soul remains above your chest, fluttering like a flag, watching everyone around you, hearing everything that's being said. And the Prophet ﷺ warns us not to be excessively miserable and crying and screaming, because we scare the soul. It can see Allah has blessed it with Jannah and everyone's crying, what are we going to do without you? How are we going to live without you? And the Prophet ﷺ said, don't do that. Let it feel comfortable. And it's at that time when the angel of death removes the soul of the believer, it recites the verses that we have in Surah Al-Fajr. Ya ayyatuha an-nafsu al-mutma'innah. O blessed, tranquil, peaceful soul. اخرجي إلى مغفرة من الله ورضوان. Enter into the forgiveness of Allah and His happiness. وَرَبُّنَا رَادٍ عَنْكِ غَيْرَ غَضْبَانٍ. And your Lord is happy with you and does not show you wrath. This is the soul of the believer traveling back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the moment we are buried and we are asked to be buried as soon as possible, and the moment our janazah is prayed, the soul rests. And there's one of three places that your soul and my soul can go. The soul of the prophets of Allah and the soul of those who have died in defense of Islam, the martyrs, al-anbiya wa shuhada, their soul enters Jannah. أَحْيَاءٌ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ يُرْزَقُونَ. They are near their Lord given rizq. They live. They don't go to sleep. The second type of soul, which is not at the highest level of the righteous, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allows it to sleep in the qabr. And the soul is at rest. And in fact, when you wake up on the Day of Judgment, Allah tells us in the Quran, people will ask, قَالُوا مَنْ بَعَثَنَا مِنْ مَرْقَدِنَا هَذَا. Who woke us up? It's almost like you just fell asleep and woke up. And the Day of Judgment is there and your entrance to Jannah is near. The third soul, also for a believer who didn't do the right thing. He believed in Allah, she believed in Allah, but had sins that were something that Allah wants to purify them with so that they don't enter Jahannam, so that they go into Jannah quickly. Allah at times may punish the soul in the grave. And some of the punishment, and the greatest punishment, is for delaying salah, not missing, but praying salah outside its time. Of not being careful when we go to the bathroom, not being careful where urine goes, not being clean with our clothes. Of spreading rumors about people and backbiting and lying about others. Those are all things mentioned by the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. After Jitat al-Siraha, the short break in this Jumu'ah, I'm going to talk to you about Salatul Janazah. And in particular, inshaAllah, we will pray Salatul Janazah lil-Ghaib. We're going to do Janazah for Brother Suhaimi's father without him present. And this was something the Prophet ﷺ did, and we do for people who are near to us that we have loved to, inshaAllah. So we will talk about this process. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم. الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعد محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. The greatest thing that we can give to someone who has passed away is dua. And the greatest deed that we can do in dua is to do it in Salatul Janazah. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says that the janazah prayer is a wajib upon the community. You can't leave a Muslim die and someone doesn't make an attempt to ask Allah for their forgiveness in that prayer. How do we pray Salatul Janazah? It doesn't have any ruku'ah, no bowing, no sujood. All it is takbir. So inshallah, after Salatul Jumu'ah, I will make the first takbir. I'm going to say Salatul Janazah lil Ghaib. You're going to make takbir like you do your prayer. Allahu Akbar, right? Those of us who put our hand on our chest, we'll put it on our chest. And then you're going to read Surah Al-Fatiha. You read it yourself, and I will read it myself, quietly. And then I will say, Allahu Akbar. That's the second takbir. After I say the second takbir, you're going to do the salah upon the Prophet ﷺ. So you're going to say, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad, kama sallayta ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim, till the end. Then I will say, Allahu Akbar. That's the third takbir. And this is when you make the dua for the deceased.